Hello, my name is Doug Hubble and welcome to Astrophotography Tutorials. Tonight I'm going to show you how to take Startrails. Startrails, you've seen these all before where they show the North Pole and you see the circle of stars rotating around it. Well, this software, Startrails, is very easy to use and it's free, and I'm going to show you how to use it. The equipment that you use for using Startrails is pretty simple stuff. I have a laptop. I have a power supply. This power supply gives it continuous power, so you can take many more than just a normal battery life. I'm using just a Nikon D60 DSLR. I've got a Nikkor 50mm 1.8 lens on it, and you need a tripod. Pretty modest equipment. Most of this stuff people have, and you can take decent star trails with this equipment. Okay, this is the setup right here. This is the DSLR. I have a 50mm lens on the front of here with just a little dew heater on the front. And what I'm trying to do with this shot with the star trail is I'm trying to pick out something that's going to be static. I chose this top of this yucca plant or whatever this plant is. It's pretty steady. The trees, they blow around in the wind. I'm going to try to use that as a foreground shot. I don't know. We'll see how that works, and then we should be able to see the star trails in the background. Just a USB cable that runs down through there right to my laptop, and power right here onto a battery, and just a simple tripod. Many of the cameras have the ability to capture photos in a sequence. The camera I'm using doesn't have that ability, so I'm using a software called Nikon Camera Control Pro, and basically I go through here and I set up my settings here, and then when I'm ready to take a time-lapse photography, I just click here and I tell it to start taking the shoots. My particular case, I'm taking 30-second exposures, and I have to wait about 55 seconds for it to download and get the image to the computer. So you'll see little dots or spots in my Startrails image. But anyway, after you do that, you just hit the start button. Okay, so the first thing you need to do is you need to go to startrails.de, and this is where you can download this software. You just simply go to the software button, click on that, and if you scroll down, you'll see a download link right here for Startrails. Just download that and install it. The author also accepts donations, and I found this software so easy to use I made a donation as well. You might enjoy giving him a small tip as well. The software, once you open it, it's very easy to use. You click right here to open up your image files, and bring up your image files, and then you select all the files you need to process. Say open, and then what you do is you just hit the Startrails button there, and as you can see, you can watch it starts to magically appear for you in front of you, right in front of your eyes. It's very neat software, very easy to use. It also has another video option too, where you can actually see the sky moving across in a video. When it gets done here, it'll kind of like average this foreground picture together. And what I did at the end of the imaging session is I took my little headlamp and I shined it over the top of this the front of this plant here, and it brightens it up, and it'll just automatically impose that over the top. Now, one of the things that you need to look at when you do this, you can see right now it's out of focus, but when I do the last few images that are in focus, the stars trails start to become out of focus. You see these big blobs right there. So what I did is I did this like what you see right here. I captured this one image, and then I did a second image without this front part in focus. And I'll show you what processing I did in Photoshop here very quickly. Here we see the foreground right here with those little dots and spots in there. That's because this image, the plant, is at a different focal point than the stars are. So what I'll do is I'll hit Control A, copy that, Control C, and then I'll go over to here,
and I'll paste this over the top of this. Now this image does not have the front plant in focus, so I'm going to paste that over the top of it. And you can see those ugly blobby stars right there, but we can take care of this easily with the layer mask. So I'll go to layer, a layer mask, hide all, and I'll get the brush tool out and I'll just simply brush this foreground piece inside here like that, and there you go. You have a nice foreground image, and you've got some nice star trails. If this is your first time watching, I would like you to subscribe. I publish 2 astrophotography videos on the 1st and 15th of every month. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you soon.